All right, welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys how to make 5.1 out of a 2-channel source. I had a subscriber comment about making 5.1 in Resolve in Fairlight. He said there wasn't a lot of tutorials out there, so I thought it was a good idea. I found this little short online called Tears of Steel, and they have an AC351, they have the individual surround, and they have a stereo mix. So I downloaded all those and brought them into Resolve here. And now I'll show you how I made the individual fake 5.1. Essentially, what you need to do is make 6 mono tracks. So I said add tracks, give me 6 monos, and made those. Then from my media pool, I took my 2-channel stereo, and you just drag it on down, and then you name everything how the layout needs to be. For anything that's left or right, you're going to use channel 1 for left and channel 2 for right. And then for your center and your LFE, you can use channel 1 and just leave that mono panned up the center. So how you can tell it which channel to use is we have A9 here, which is going to be our left channel. You right click it. And you go down to clip attributes, and then you pop up, it says mono, and we want that to be listening to embedded channel 1, and you hit OK. As I said, the center doesn't matter because it's mono. The right needs, that's going to be channel 2. And then do the same thing for your left surround and your right surround. So channel 1 for left and channel 2 for right. And now these all have individual discrete tracks. And here they are on the right. And then what we need to do is pan them. So here's our left front. So I pan that to the left front. And then for our center channel, it's panned right up the middle. And our right channel to the right front. Our LFE straight to the middle. And also turn on this boom. And that lets the 5.1 bus know that that is an LFE channel. I just turned it on and cranked it. And then for our left surround, right surround, you could see left surrounds in the back left corner and the opposite for the right surround. So now here's where you tell it what to do. Otherwise, it wouldn't be going into a 5.1 sort of output. You need to send it to a new bus. So you can see we have fake 5.1. What you do is under your Fairlight drop-down menu, hit bus format. And you can add or take away buses in here. So as you can see, we got bus 1 says 5.1 film, discrete bus, same thing. And then I have fake 5.1, which is 5.1. And you could change these even though they're active if you needed to. So under the 5.1, here's our options. And the difference between 5.1 and 5.1 film is just the layout. So whether it's going to be left, center, right, or left, right, center, that's how that layout changes between those two options. So you can see we got a 6-channel 5.1. I colored it green and I hit add. Here's the little box if you wanted to see what it looks like. It just adds a bus. You can rename it by double clicking and then change the config. And that's how you add a 5.1 bus. So now we have each one going out. All you do is pick the bus here. And then here is the actual bus. Bus 3 is named fake 5.1. As you can see, it's got the 6 channels inside. And if we solo out the center here and hit play, you can see it's going to the center channel here. I can't get these meters any bigger. I wish they would get bigger, or maybe a third-party plugin to show the spread. We do have these surround analyzers, and they are effects plugins. So you could see this one's on the fake 5.1, and the one on the left is on the AC3. I did that so I could compare what the real mix was doing versus what our little fake 5.1 was doing. So if we watch those, you can kind of see in comparison the actual 5.1 and the fake one we did. As you could see, the real 5.1's got a little more spatial dynamic range and everything. So as you can see, it doesn't quite look the same, but it's not bad for a 2-channel. Your passion. And then what I did was just adjust the faders. As you could see, the left and rights are a little lower than the center because the center is the most important. LFE are brought down, and then the surrounds I kind of brought down in between the two. So they're not quite as loud as the left and rights, which is usually how it gets mixed in my experience. And the only other things we did here is we got a couple EQs on. So for the center channel, I rolled off some of the lows, a little bit of the extreme highs, and gave it a little boost in the middle to kind of help dialogue cut through. And then on the LFE channel, I pretty much rolled off all the highs and just said, let all the low information pass. And that's how you can take a two channel and make a faux 5.1 mix. That's how you bus it, lay out your tracks, and mix it or balance it. And if we look here down at the faders, here's our 5.1 mix on channel 1, A1. That's the creator's 5.1. Bus 3 is ours. So if we take these tracks out and kind of just look at the balance between these two. So now if we look at the bottom right here and just play them.
Be tender to her. Be honest. Be tender. Remind her.
Let's go to a little louder section. Let me mute this AC3.
That's nice.
Fair about amount of difference between the two, but you could probably do a little bit of automation on these discrete tracks right here. Would be like my next go-to. Would open these up and maybe do some panning automation and stuff. That could probably lend some credibility to give it a little more width. If it gave it, maybe watch it through if you were going to mix it, if there was objects coming across the screen, that kind of stuff, since that information isn't as wide in the two-channel mix. And just so you know, underneath your preview monitor here or your window, you have a little drop-down menu. This is actually what you're going to be listening to. So if we went over here to the fake 5.1, that's actually what's coming out my monitor. And then if I go over to the AC3, now we're actually listening to the AC3. You'll see that the levels all change and everything like that. So very important, even though you might have something muted down here, it's actually this little drop down going into the automation is what you're actually monitoring. So, all right. Thanks for watching. As always, leave a comment if you got some other kind of video you want me to touch on. I hope that helps, and I'll see you guys on the next video.